And the lighting got better.
Yes.
It got diffused.
Hi there. I am Nikki with the Mike and Nikki's Honey Company. We are in, God help us, episode 2, 3, 4, who knows? I'm just filming everything. We're at the Campbell Farm. This is our original farm. This is where we started it all. We're now up to 15 apiaries all over the Greater Bay Area. And our commercial bees travel all over California and Nevada. But the boutique bees, who usually don't get a job, are at Tracy, pollinating almonds. They could make some money and pay for themselves. So we thought, you get a job. It's just like working at the Burger King for these. It's a short period of time, and then they'll be back home sitting on the porch. Today we have Jen from Bulgaria. The Bulgarian Honey Company is coming here to visit. They started, she got her, I'd proudly say, her first beekeeping lessons right here.
I did.
In this very yard.
This exact apiary.
She wore the Michelin tire suit, as always can. I'm sure we can find a clip for her. We'll cut in a picture of her in her bee suit.
I have one.
And she started, because you got to be bad before you can be good, and good before you can be great. Honey is an oral history society. We talk with each other. We help each other. We don't mind if I beat you in sales on something else, but we're always here to help each other. Hey, I got a bottle producer in Germany. Okay, let's see if it makes sense for us, because I spent 4.5 months finding lids this year. Well, we want to work together. We want to survive together, and we're going to succeed together. So, Jen, what have you found so exciting in your first year of commercial beekeeping?
Oh, gosh. I mean, this was completely new to me. When I met Nikki first, I actually just married my husband, who came from a 4-generation beekeeping tradition within his family. So before I was going to move to Bulgaria and learn beekeeping from his mother, who doesn't speak English, I thought maybe I should find someone here in America who can teach me how to beekeep in English. Might be a little bit easier. And Nikki and I actually worked together in the financial services industry. And then I casually found out that she has, at the time, 70 beehives on the side, you know, just...
Everyone's got a side hustle, and we're a hobby that ran amok.
And so I asked her to teach me beekeeping. So since I moved to Bulgaria, it's very different from here, because we beekeep in the villages at the foot of the Balkan Mountains. We don't truck our bees, and it's very just...
Yeah, yours are non... like our boutique bees are non-migratory. I mean, this is their summer job of pollinating the almonds, because it brings the cash register. Mm-hmm. During COVID, it makes a good sense, but... Our boutique bees stay home. They live on the porch and live their days in one place, whereas most American bees have a job on my tractor trailer.
Always working.
Yeah, always working. Rolling. You know, they're out there working, and so we're balancing the two. And the boutique hives was an opportunity to make some more money for keeping the honey company going, because if you haven't noticed, honey's expensive. So when you see those $2 a pound jars, it's probably foreign. It's probably... been a barrel for a while. The honey market's having a hard time right now. What we're wanting to do is we want to keep the prices up high enough to pay for the gas, the beekeeper, the processing, the jar, the clean facility, and the label, and then get it into the store. At $2 a pound, a lot of beekeepers are leaving their honey in the hives. And what's that going to do when you're not getting American honey anymore? These are the things we're going to have to do. This is what we've signed up for.
We have a Bulgarian honey too. Is there's a lot of price bullying, because Bulgaria is a low cost of living country. It's in the EU, so they still have to abide by all the EU quality regulations. But there's these big buyers, and there's a lot of people in the gray economy who are afraid to register, who are afraid to pay taxes, or just they've never done accounting before. They're not educated about it. And so one of the things we want to do is we want to actually help Bulgarian farmers legalize their companies, learn to apply for subsidies, learn how to run their business so that they can actually market themselves at market value in the global economy.
So it's going to be an interesting time as we learn to bring honey prices up so that we can survive, because we pollinate your local tomatoes.
That's right.
We pollinate all that lovely stuff that's in your neighborhood. So if you want a cucumber in your local salad, I suggest you buy some local honey. So, I'm Nikki with the Mike and Nikki Honey Company, and our guest today is...
Jen from Bulgarian Honey Company.
We'll put the links down below for Instagram, Facebook. I think I'm on Twitter. God help me, I'm not doing TikTok. Are you doing TikTok?
No, not yet.
No TikTok, so sad. Because we're busy beekeeping.
So be sure to subscribe.
Yeah, so like, ring that little bell. Do all that stuff you like to do in a 2021 style. And I will see you at the next apiary.